Everyone, what's going on? It's Austin here with the Upswing Report. And today's video, it's pretty relevant. It's June outside, birds are chirping, sun's out there, and people are making fashion mistakes. So what I did to help you guys out is I put together the 7 fashion mistakes or style mistakes guys make during the summer months. So let's get right into it. Also, for a lot of these things, if I can, to make it easier for you guys, I'm gonna put the link below to the Amazon product listing. So if you wanna go in there and buy them, go right ahead. Boom, I just changed my shirt into this Oxford. A lot of guys wearing dress shirts like this will not properly roll up their sleeve. They'll either just take the sleeves and mash them up like this, and not only does that look sloppy, the sleeves will also pretty much all the time always just come down. What you're gonna do here is you're gonna unbutton your shirt all the way up to your elbow, and then what you're gonna do is you're gonna roll it up one more time. And once you do this, now it's gonna look a lot more cool, calm in the summer. You don't have to go all the way up as high as it did here. Basically stop a little bit before your elbow, much more presentable, as opposed to just mashing up your sleeves and hoping they stay up. The second mistake is using heavy fabrics or fabrics that are made for the fall and winter months, wearing them during the summer. Wools, heavy cottons. First, it looks pretty bad. Second, and pretty much most importantly, is you're gonna sweat like a freaking pig. A couple of my favorite materials that I like to use, these are some seersucker shorts that I got from Izod. These guys are awesome. They look really cool and they breathe very, very well. Another favorite of mine is the chambray. Basically looks like jean, and you can actually wear this in a sense like a jean jacket. I think you can get even shorts too for them. I don't have any shorts, but I think they look great. Again, it's gonna be very breathable in the summer. Also, just your basic cotton, like 100% cotton, very breathable, stylish, and comfortable. Win-win. Third mistake that I see guys wearing are socks and sneakers. If you're wearing tube socks and you got like the skater vibe kind of going on, streetwear, that's a good look. But unfortunately, most guys aren't trying to do that. They're usually wearing shorts and socks that go at or above their ankle. It's not a good look. Don't do it. Get some no-show socks, get some fresh white sneakers, and you're gonna be balling out. I like to work out. I go to the gym. Pair of gym shorts, not a bad look when you're at the gym. And you can pull them off outside of the gym too. But if you're always wearing gym shorts and just boring or plain t-shirt, you're not wearing proper footwear, then you look like a dweeb. Yeah, they might be comfortable, but you look like you're not on the upswing. So that's a no-go. Fifth style tip that I don't see a lot of guys using in the summer are wearing some accessories. So these could be sunglasses, lava beads, a watch. You don't have to wear them all at once. You can combine them, but here's the thing. When it's summer, it's really hot outside, so you're not gonna be wanting to wear a lot of layers in terms of your clothing. So you're limited to kind of what you can pick. So a great way to basically differentiate yourself is to wear some accessories. Something as simple even as just a Timex watch like this one, I think is like 30 bucks you can get on Amazon or even at Walmart. Another great style accessory that a lot of guys just miss out on is something like a fabric belt, just like this. I'm gonna add that extra pizzazz to your style that a lot of guys just miss out on. Grab some accessories and rock out. All right, dudes, I know you've heard this one before, but wear some sunscreen, guys. Get some for your facial moisturizer. This stuff is SPF 15, some protection from the sun so that you're not gonna get wrinkles and even worse, cancer down the road. Take care of yourself, take care of your skin. Also, when you're going outside, your shirts are off, if you're at the beach, wherever, you're gonna be wanting to use just normal sunscreen. This is just from CVS, it's really cheap. This is SPF 30. Spray it on, get some sunscreen. The Red Lobster look is totally not good and you guys need to wear some sunscreen. Seventh tip, we're talking about the beach. Well, you're not gonna wanna be wearing one of those parachute sized swimsuits. I know I'm a little daring. Yeah, I have one of these European style, really short swimsuits that I think look great, but not saying that you should wear one of these. Even this one, I got this one from Old Navy back a couple years ago. It's still holding up really great. Basically just try to get a swimsuit that's not gonna go past your knees, maybe do 2 to 3 inches above your knees, and it's not, again, like a freaking fluff ball. When you're on the beach, you're also on the upswing. One last bonus tip and a mistake that I see guys wearing is they'll just wear boring t-shirts or really loud, obnoxious graphic tees. T-shirts look great. You get your black, your white, and you get your gray. You can't really go wrong with that. But if you're always wearing that and you kind of want to switch something up, don't just go with the crew neck, something that's just a basic fit. This one has kind of like a raw neck cut or scoop neck. Go for something kind of different like that. This is called a muscle tee, where the sleeves are automatically kind of rolled up. That just accentuates your muscles and it looks just different. Go out there and try different couple fits and see what happens. All right, guys, there you have it. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you like this video. In addition to that, if you wouldn't mind sharing it on your social media, I would really appreciate it. Watch out for these summer mistakes so you guys can make sure everybody knows that you're on the upswing. I'll see you in the next video. Peace out, guys.